Loser Maddow swears Trump killed 4 U.S. soldiers, president gives her an epic smackdown. Rachel Maddow's crazy conspiracy theories have reached an all-time low. Her program last Thursday night was so incredibly off the wall, even leftists were embarrassed for her. She went on a 25-minute rant, alleging that President Donald Trump had gotten 4 U.S. soldiers killed single-handedly. Even though she was highly criticized, she doubled down on her nut job theory Friday, and that's when Trump had enough. He delivered an epic smackdown to Maddow, one she surely won't forget. Rachel Maddow claims Donald Trump's latest travel ban caused 4 Green Berets to be killed in Niger. Maddow essentially claimed that the inclusion of Chad, which recently pulled its troops out of Niger, in the revised travel ban resulted in extremist attacks such as the one that left 4 Americans dead. Really? Well, you just can't make this stuff up. In fact, even Huffington Post, a huge liberal website, was telling Rachel to get back on her meds. The Huffington Post piece was titled, "What the Hell Was This Rachel Maddow Segment?" and reports that Maddow claims, Chad's pullout from Niger had an immediate effect in emboldening ISIS attacks. That allegation appears to be completely false. According to the Council on Foreign Relations and accounts from local residents, the attacks that have increased can be traced back to the militant group Boko Haram, which is based just across the border in Nigeria. Colby College Department of Government Assistant Professor Laura Shea said that any expert would have said Maddow's conspiracy theory was crazy and the pullout of Chadian troops isn't necessarily related to the Trump's travel ban. Everybody that I know is appalled by this. I would like to think that Maddow's researchers are more responsible, Shea told Huffington Post. Wow, you know it's really bad when the hardcore leftists are telling Rachel Maddow that she sounds like a tinfoil hat wearer. It's so blatantly over the top wacky, you might think she would quietly back away from the claims. Nope. In fact, the MSNBC host decided that, despite her critics, she would double down on the Chad Niger Trump conspiracy. Over the course of the day today, lots of people have been very upset with me for reporting that last night, which is fine. I didn't know you cared. But the upset over my reporting doesn't mean that anything I reported wasn't true, Maddow said. Everything I reported was true. President Trump really wants to thank Rachel Maddow, and here's why. Her unrivaled hate of Trump has taken her to dark, scary places. She is unraveling on live TV. For months, she was the biggest promoter of the Russia narrative. Every day, she was on edge, promising her audience that Trump, without any doubt, colluded with the Kremlin to get elected and that he would be impeached any day now. Of course, that never happened. What did happen was the truth came out, and it was Hillary Clinton and Barack Obama who were colluding with Vladimir Putin as they sold out 22% of our country's uranium stores to Russia. Maddow got that memo, and it burned her badly. Her ratings along with any reputation she had left tanked. Maddow's producers had seen a correlation between her Russia Trump fake news segments to her previous higher ratings. Then, Sean Hannity took over the 9 p.m. slot at the end of September, and those high ratings plummeted. So, she had to invent another conspiracy, and it seems her producers loved making Trump's travel ban the reason U.S. soldiers are dead. As for President Trump, he didn't miss a beat. Seeing Maddow's breakdown and her cohorts abandoning her over her Trump killed U.S. soldiers theory, he tweeted, "It is finally sinking through. 46% of people believe major national news orgs fabricate stories about me. Fake news, even worse. Lost cred." Rachel Maddow's big meltdown on election night has never really ended. Like so many other hardcore liberals, the night Trump won the presidency was the beginning of their eventual end. They have gone full-blown into fantasy land with their reporting. They are obsessed with Trump, and like Rachel Maddow, he is getting the last laugh on them. The Huffington Post's Will Ifred wrote that Maddow built myths, using unrelated or unreliable information and reduced the story so thoroughly that it lost any semblance of the larger truth. In other words, Rachel Maddow is a big fat liar, who had a nervous breakdown over Trump on live TV. Anyone who watched her show even a few times since the election saw this coming. We are just shocked it took this long.